Andro?
Now that the Majut's got a mouthful of bonbon gummy and the brand new sit-tight is in place...
Sana, you're there.
Noko's been training another fantabulous little critter that'll hopefully be...
Masama.
She's called them Glittermoths.
Asilnatu.
You'll find Mito at Brightlight. He's a...
Kamonu.
Treat it fair time, and the mount will return the favor. Let's see. With the world getting darker by the day, no matter where, wonders if you know how much of an effect you've had upon, wishes you could see your way toward using your fire to light the way in the world, rather than burn it down. Stunned that you decided the world wasn't worth saving, what was it that burned you? Thinks it's funny you worked with the Jagni. They tried to rob him once, but he scorched away any that got too close. Says he can see by the twinkle in your eyes that he assumes you are here to be enlightened. He can't... There's something about you, like you're knit together. He senses you're like the dayfly. Living says it's pronounced that way, but spelt different. Mito says he's not only into those who shine bright, he reckons you haven't seen a glitter moth, and says it's about time you did. Finding yourself a glitter moth would give you that glimmer of hope you need to... Hide or hunt tonight. That's your call. too tight and the rope tips. Glittermoth Cave is right here. The night feels dangerous and exciting. That's sure to be useful. This place is called Brightlight. Mito lives close by. Mito says there's darkness in everyone. His goal in this dying world is to... That's enough, Glittermoths. She wants you to stop worrying about the paths you've ridden and focus on the inevitable road ahead. The hoof puff is evidence of the duality of evolution. She means that the hoof puff has had more time to eat at the root. So, based on that alone, she reckons it has suffered as much damage as the northwest root. Dawn must be coming soon, because it's awfully dark right now. Thank you. The best stories are about heroes. This is such a story. That sealed the fate of the third World Eater. Just one more to go. Out of Date asked to see you again to congratulate you and let you in on the final phases of his plan. This is your chance to get his priorities aligned with yours. Take control of the situation and make sure your goals become his. Just head back to the Ark. He seemed eager to see you again. Go on, catch it. Wonder where we can get some ride shoes for the mount. Noko knows she's known for saying things over again. Understands completely. Noko knows she's known for saying things over again. Has split. It's like a whole different world down here. Whoops.
Ifari kobo far.
Out of date says there'll be consequences of the war.
Ko buboye buy.
The last World Eater has been left undisturbed with the tree while you focused on the...
Yamoluvando.
He guessed someone with your dark perspective and key would prioritize resolving the tribe war before...
Fabube muk kofar.
Regardless, Out of Date is grateful the tribe war is over. Out of Date understands the road has been rough, but you already know what's left to end this journey. You're the only one that's strong enough to face the last World Eater. The New World Order can only be achieved by someone with a dark perspective, even if that means letting the final World Eater attack the tree too. Only time will tell what the future holds. Out of Date says the word about what you've done so far is spreading. The tribes haven't lost hope yet. He appreciates what you've done so far, but he says he'll point you in the right direction. That doesn't sound good. Out of Date's hunch is real. The Merc Puff is up next. Out of Date says that Wiz is worried now that the Northwest World Eater is stepping up. He explains that Wiz is working on an undersurf vessel in order to get to the World Eater. Out of Date suggests that you should head northwest as... He's happy to help.